Hi students, let us continue with the thumb. In the previous video I explained about the thumb architecture. Now let's see the thumb instruction set. So I said each and whatever the ARM core you are going to be selected, so those core may be work on any of the operation like ARM by default or the thumb or ZZL. So each of this mode, whatever the mode you are taken, will have their own instruction set. So ARM is having their own instruction set, which is of that 32 bit long. Okay, so there the first bits are 31 to some 28, it is going to be selected for the 0 bit, sign bit, overflow bit like that, and the remaining is for future use, and 1 bit is going to be selected whether it is a thumb or not. So that is completely CPSR. Actually it is the ARM consisting of complete, it is all the registers will be there. So how many registers will be there from R0 to R31? It's a registers will be there. So in this you are having from R0 to R15 as they used for the purpose, and the remaining is for the special status registers. Okay, so this is a ARM instruction set. So in that the special CPSR is one of the special registers. So with the help of the CPSR register, which is also a 32 bit size, with the help of the CPSR register, we are going to, it is going to indicate whether the thumb instruction is enabled or disabled. Okay. So coming to this thumb instruction set, it is a compressed form of ARM. So I already said the thumb is a compressed form of ARM. Here the instruction stored in as 16 bit, decompressed into ARM instruction and executed. So if you see that the previous diagram, whatever has I shown you, so in that previous diagram, instruction stored as a 16 bit and decompressed. So let me show you that architecture. Okay, so just wait. So first the instruction stored as 16 bit, next decompressed ARM into ARM instruction, one decoder will be there, and then finally it is going to be executed. The thumb encodes a subset of 32 bit instruction set into a 16 bit subspace. So this is one of the feature. The thumb encodes a subset of 32 bit instruction set. It's generally it is a 32 bit instruction set which is converted into 16 bit subspace. So that way instructions are stored as a 16 bit. Thumb has higher performance than ARM. So this point you remember that the thumb has higher performance than ARM on a processor with a 16 bit data bus. So it's having a 16 bit data bus. The thumb has higher code density that saves up to 30% space. So with the help of this higher code density, the thumb is going to save the 30% space in the processor. For memory constrained embedded system, and only low registers R0 to R7 is fully accessible. So it is a 16 bit data bus, it's having the 16 bit data bus we said. So in that only from R0 to R7 is fully accessible by the all the, means it's a user registers, user friendly registers. Only those registers it can be fully accessed by the programmers. Higher registers are accessible with move, add, compare instructions. Means the actually it is R0 to R15. Total 16 registers are there. So in this R0 to R7 is fully accessible by the programmers. Okay. And the remaining registers are, these are the low registers. And next will be the R8 to R15 will be there. These are the high registers, and these registers are accessible with move, add, compare instructions. Means it is set for the opcodes. Operation has to be performed. These registers are preferred for the opcode, reserved for the opcode. A barrel shifter operations are separate instructions. Here the push pop for stack manipulation, so which is descending the stack pointer hardware to R13. Okay, so here R13 is used reserved for the stack manipulations. and the ARM entered automatically after reset or entering exception mode. So whenever you are going to reset that, it is next the ARM is entered automatically. The maximum it's having 255 SWI calls. So this is a instruction set of thumb instruction set. So it's here they are saying that the thumb instruction set is actually it is encoded a subset of 32-bit instruction set into 16 subspaces only. So here it is having the 16-bit data bus will be there, okay, and it is a higher performance than ARM. And you remember that in the 16-bit, R0 to R7 is fully accessible registers. They are the low registers and the high registers are R8 to R15. And these are reserved for some of the opcodes like move, addition, compare instructions like that. Okay, the operations has to be performed. In that, the R13 will be for static manipulations. Okay. Thank you.